I'm real happy to bring out my next guest. He's a very funny man. We worked together in the past, but this is the first chance he's had to come on our show. Say hello to Mr. Louis C.K., ladies and gentlemen. How are you?
Good to see you.
Welcome.
Thanks.
I'm glad you're finally here.
Yeah, me too.
I really am. Were you coming all the way from New York?
Yeah, New York. The only city in the world where you actually have to say things like, hey, that's mine, don't pee on that. Which, well, you get in all these situations there. You never see anywhere else.
Wait a second. Let's not point out how many people in New York would say, hey, that's mine, please pee on that. You know, that also happens.
You always find yourself in situations you'd find nowhere. You know, like, I was walking home one night, there was a guy in front of my building, and he was beating the crap out of some guy. Just laying him out. All of a sudden, he stopped and he looked at me. And you know what he said? He said, do you know what time it is? This guy's asked me the time, and I knew, but I didn't really want to tell him because he's beating the crap out of this guy. But then I thought, maybe he's beating the crap out of him because he wouldn't tell him what time it is. You know, so I told him, but I was off by about 5 minutes. You know, I don't fight crime, but I do disorient criminals whenever I have a chance. Don't mess with me, I'll throw you way off schedule. You'll be late for your next mugging. I am Snow Watch Man.
I love that. Look, what time is it? Because I've got another beating across town. Well, you know, New York gets a lot of bad press, but hey, you know, at least it's a violent city.
Yeah. Well, I gave birth to the first mass murderer, probably, Son of Sam.
Well, I don't know if he was the first, but he was certainly one of the better ones.
Yeah, he's up there.
He's definitely one of the big top 10.
You know what I hated about him was his whole excuse for what he did was...
That's what you hated about
him? That's what I hated about him.
All right, just checking.
Yeah. Well, he killed a bunch of people, and he said his dog told him to do it. You know, now, if you have a talking dog, right? Fine, your dog talks, but if he tells you to kill somebody, that's when you go, no, bad dog. It's a dog. He poops in the yard. He's making career decisions for this guy, you know?
If you have a talking dog, go on Star Search. Yeah, you know, do something productive.
Exactly. Probably a lot of people have talking dogs now. I don't listen to him. He's an idiot. He's a dog. What is he going to do about life and death?
What's he going to say? You know, if you lick these, they clean up like that. Hey, Louis?
Yeah.
See, I don't know how these guys get away with stuff. Mass murderers, somehow, they get away with mass murder. Yeah. I can't get illegal cable. Yeah. I can never get away with anything.
Well, that's the thing. I don't think you appreciate the justice system until you become a criminal. You know, like, I was in jail once in New Jersey. I got pulled over, and the guy said my license.
Which, by the way, is the best part of being in New Jersey.
The best part of New Jersey is I was happy to get off the highway. But, they say my license was suspended, which is not true because I never had a license in my life. But anyway, so I had to go to Jersey City County Jail, and I had to be strip searched by some guy. So I'm standing, I have to stand up for this. You know, I'm staying naked in front of this cop. And he looks at me and he goes, all right, lift your testicles. And I was like, well, can I use my hands? Or do you just want me to go, rise, testicles! Rise on my command!
Which, by the way, could also get you on Star Search. Do you have a lot of friends here in L.A.?
Only a few. I actually ran into one today, out of the few people that I know here. This friend of mine saw me across the street and he waved to me. And I wanted to wave back, but I was eating a peach with one hand and I had a newspaper the other. So I didn't know which one to wave. I guess since I'm right-handed, I waved the peach. Yeah. I felt like I was going, look, I have a peach! What a fine peach it is! I am very fruitful indeed!
You always have that great voice for some reason when you're in these situations.
That's my whole act. The only thing I have.
Look!
That's the only voice I do. I could be talking about my mother calling me, hello, son, yes? My whole act.
You have a knack of getting in these awkward situations for some reason.
Oh, yeah. Like, I saw this guy today, and I thought I knew him, but you ever see somebody that you don't know again?
Yeah. I actually know what you're talking about.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Somebody that's a total stranger, but he keeps popping up once in a while.
You never met the guy, but you
see
him.
You see him all the time. Like, God is running out of extras in a movie of your life or something. He's reusing people. All right, go be a shopper. I was just a jogger. Just go. Put a hat on. I don't care. Get in there. I got myself in a really weird situation the other day. I went to buy some stuff. I went grocery shopping, and I forgot to have money. You know? I just forgot to get cash, so I'm sitting, the guy bags all the stuff, and he goes, $55, and I go, I don't need money. You know? And he's like, what are you talking about? I said, I'm broke, I have no money. And I didn't have any other options, so I just said to him, well, can I just take this stuff for free? And it occurred to me that you should do that anytime you buy anything. You know, just ask if you can have it for free. Because it can't hurt anything. You might hit the one guy that goes, yeah, go ahead. I don't care. Take it. So he gave it to me.
He gave it to you, did not.
No, the whole thing's a lie. It never happened.
I know that. I know
that. Well, nothing happens to me, so I have to... You know, like, you ever do this, you tell somebody a story, and then a week later you tell them the same story again because you forgot. And by this time you've embellished it and added lies to it and made it bigger and...
Like the one you just told.
Like the one I just... I always get in my trouble lying. Like, the other day I was telling a guy a funny story about something that happened to me, but it didn't really happen to me. It happened to somebody else, and I was lying, and I was saying it was me, and all of a sudden I realized that I was talking to the guy that it happened to. You lie, even in the most intimate situations, like... when you're having sex with somebody, and it's just so phony, you know? You get into that moaning thing, what is that? What do you saw it in a movie, so you're doing it? Is it, you know, I think mostly it's kind of a device to communicate, to let the person know they're in the right area, kind of a homing beacon, you know? Beep, beep, yes, continue that, yes, that's... It's a very fruitful venture you're embarking upon. Yes, I like your work.
Once again...
I'd love to do that to somebody I'm having sex with, just to freak her out. In the heat of passion, all of a sudden you go...
Louis C.K., ladies and gentlemen. We give away stuff free.
I'm right.
No, 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 I'm right.
I'm right.